Ah, good evening, Jean. Wait, where's Lisa? She's supposed to be in here.
Lisa, the Grandmaster's letter is just on the table.
Is it gonna be horny?
Traveler, Paimon, it's been a long time. Apologies, I didn't get the chance to talk with you during the meeting just now.
Yeah, I'm so crushed.
If you don't have any plans in the immediate future, why not stay in Mondstadt for a while? We'll be celebrating the Vine Lisa Fest very soon.
Don't be deceived. Jean may appear very composed, but she's been missing you both terribly recently.
Lisa.
I'll leave you to catch up. I'm going to read my letter.
Can I be personal or not as personal?
Yeah, Mondstadt's where our journey began, after all. We have a lot of fond memories here.
It's true, actually. She's not wrong.
Master Jean, neither of us really knows anything about this Vine Lisa Fest. Could you tell us more about it?
Yes, of course. The Vine Lisa Fest is an ancient Mondstadt festival, just like Ludi Harpastum in Windbloom. In addition, it's the most important part of the fall. Each fall, the west wind blows in Mondstadt. Legend has it that the wonderful scent of Mondstadt's winemaking during the harvest season entices even the Animo Archon into attendance, being the great wine lover that he is. No matter where he is, he will transform into a soft breeze and return to his homeland.
Yeah, that sounds like the Animo Archon, all right.
For this reason, Mondstadters call the western wind the returning wind. The Vine Lisa Fest originally began as a celebration to welcome Lord Barbados on his return. In the past, every household would brew fresh wine around this time of year and keep it sealed at least until Windcoming Day during the following year's Vine Lisa Fest. Uncasking the sealed wine is a symbolic way of inviting the Animo Archon to share a drink. Legend holds that if the Animo Archon is satisfied with the taste of the wine, he will summon a gentle breeze to richly bless the people.
Knowing him, it was probably blessing them with more good wine the next year.
That's a good question. But there's really no way of knowing. These are very old stories. Many of the details have been lost to time.
Yep, that'll happen. Some stories change completely as they get passed down. Hence why these days, Mondstadters will get into endless arguments over what kind of flower a windbloom is.
References to previous shit we've
done. Part of how cultural heritage is created.
Indeed. But for the time being, at least, the tradition of paying tribute to the Animo Archon on Windcoming Day is still alive and well, and the Vine Lisa Fest remains a time for Mondstadters to share the joy of the harvest with one another as they partake of fine wines. This is a time of the year when many Mondstadters living away from Mondstadt return to their hometown. For those unable to return, Vine Lisa Fest is the period when they miss their family and friends most keenly.
Oh, so that's why the Grandmaster wrote, "May the wind carry our sentiments back to your side."
For this year, we've joined forces with the Church of Favonius and the Adventurers Guild to host a celebration on the banks of Cider Lake, just outside of Springvale. There will also be a traditional wine market during the festival period.
Wine market?
Well, originally, it was simply a place where winemakers and farmers would come to trade in raw ingredients for winemaking. These days, it is a much grander affair. Not only will you find a range of choice wines, but seasonal fruit beverages and food items for everyone to enjoy too. A lot of people also sell secondhand goods and handicrafts at the market. The Knights of Favonius plan to use this as an opportunity to do some fundraising for needy children and elderly people in the city.
Wow, sounds pretty cool!
If you have the time, I encourage you to take a look around. I hope you'll find it a worthwhile experience. Lisa, what was the Grandmaster's message to you about?
I was just about to bring that up. The Grandmaster says he wants me to handle something for him. Something to do with Razor's past.
Razor told us that he was raised by a pack of wolves in Wolvingdom. He never knew his parents. In his own words, the wolf pack is his lupical, which means family.
Yes, that was as much as I knew as well. But in his letter, the Grand Master says that in the cabinet above the third bookshelf, to the right of the grandfather clock in Jean's office, there's a wooden box containing some items that Razor's parents left for him. He says it's time to give the box to Razor.
Does this mean the Grand Master knew Razor's parents?
It would seem so. The Grand Master didn't simply run into Razor one day in Wolvendom and teach him how to use a sword. No. The connection between them goes back much further.
Wow! Well, come on! Let's go find Razor! He'll be pretty excited to find out something about his true parents!
Oh, cutie. Nothing escapes your eyes, does it? For the child who never met their biological parents, this kind of conversation is always a difficult one, even for the most well-adjusted. By contrast, Razor grew up in Wolvendom and has had very limited contact with human society. Who knows whether he's ready for this or not?
I'm sure the Grand Master will have given due consideration to Razor's circumstances. Perhaps he felt that now would be the most appropriate time.
That's a good point. Okay, cuties, can I leave you to break the news to Razor? He is his teacher, so he might not open up to me if he gets upset. But you are his trusted friends. I think it makes more sense for him to hear about this from you. Thank you, sweetie. Try to be as encouraging as you can. Someone his age needs all the love and support they can get.
Is there something else you would like to discuss? It was good of Mika to bring the letter back all this way. Knowing that everyone is safe and sound is the best encouragement I could ask for. Still, I hadn't counted on the captain making an appearance. The Grand Master has a rather unconventional way of describing things. But even then, I've never heard him give such high recognition to anyone before. If you ever encounter the captain on your own journey, be on your guard. He is not someone to be underestimated.
Well, I've learned that when it comes to harbingers.
Is there something else you would like to discuss? Mika tells me that rather than rejoining the expedition party, Grandmaster told him to return to his post in Eula's reconnaissance company after delivering the letter. Land surveyors are usually situated in the vanguard of an army on the move, and are tasked with exploring previously uncharted territory. It looks like the expedition must have entered into a much less intense phase. Have you had the chance to speak with Mika yet? When he's with people he hasn't met before, he tenses up and stands bolt upright.
Yeah, and he also bolted
as
well.
I really wish he had a little more self-confidence. Is there something else you would like to discuss? There is still some preparation to do, but don't worry, everything's on track. Actually, while we're on the topic, I have an assignment I'd like to give you. Namely, enjoy the festival to the fullest. Any objections? Is there something else you would like to discuss? Goodbye. I wish you a very pleasant Vine Lisa Fest.
As his teacher, I have a duty to give him the best education and guidance that I can. I'll make sure I'm prepared by the time you get back. Go on now, cuties. I'll leave Razor in your hands.
Jeez, stop calling me cutie. Yeah, I must have pulled some wicked frickin'.
Razor's usually around Wolvendom, right? How do you think he'll react after hearing about this?
Wait, but we didn't ask about the cat at all. And she's still standing here. She walked off just to stop right here. Let me see, is that a... I guess it just... what? Good lord, some of these are like 10 years old. Holy shit. Oh my god, hold on. Oh my god, oh my god, is this for Jean's story quest, the cat thing? Is that why Paimon's voice was so different? Because it's from the old version of the game? And not part of the current event? And it just happened to overlap with the event, which is why I got confused. Oh, that would make total sense. Okay. That might be what's going on. Okay. But yeah, I was talking about this. I must have pulled a wicked frickin' muscle in my neck yesterday. Because I don't remember. I just twisted my neck, you know, to look at my other monitor. And I suddenly felt the sharp pain. And then now it's almost as if I have a stiff neck. But it hurts really freaking bad. And the whole pain shoots from my back of my neck down my left arm when I try to move my head to the... Down and to the left is when it happens. But up into the right it does as well, but down into the right it doesn't. So it's like when I twist a certain way, which made sleeping interesting because I like to lay on my side and that was quite difficult to do. But it seems that the pain is subsiding a little bit more than when I first felt it. How easy it is just to make your body hurt. What is over here? Okay, it looks like we've got a nice collection of a lot of stuff. Iron. White iron. And crystal. Holy shit. Klee, look at all this shit that you get to pick up. There's a bear trap here. The frick?
Hey, look! It's a hunting trap. It looks like the ones that the hunters from Springvale use. What is it?
Traces of electro energy.
Electro energy? Paimon wonders if it could be Razor. But Paimon thought he was pretty good at avoiding the hunters. Well, anyway, let's follow the traces of Electro and see where they lead.
That is not the way we were facing.
Look! There's another trap up ahead! And can you feel that Electro energy too? Traces lead deep into Wolvendom. Let's keep going.
Yeah, but I get to loot everything again. So have some patience, little Paimon. There's claw marks now. Although I think there's always been claw marks. How does that block? That's so stupid!
Jumpy Dumpty!
Up.
All right, the last trap has been set. Razor, thanks for coming with me all this way.
Okay. It's okay. My legs are strong. Hmm?
What is it, Razor?
It smells familiar. Friend, from far away.
Razor! Oh, and it's draft too! Are you two hunting together?
Yes, it's almost harvest season, and the boars are venturing into the towns and wineries looking for food. They're trampling crops and destroying the vineyards. Someone could get seriously hurt. The Knights of Favonius came to us asking for help, keeping the boars a safe distance away from the population.
I and Uncle Browncat catch boars, protect everyone.
Uncle Browncat.
Whoa, Razor! This is a big step for you. Paimon remembers you used to hide away from the hunters.
You can say that again. Razor was the star of the show this time. He let the wolves know we'd be coming, so we were able to get through Wolvendom without anyone getting hurt.
Helping everyone, helping Lupacall, makes me happy. But much talking. Very tired now.
Yeah! But, actually, we came here today because we have some really important news.
You tell Razor about the important news.
Oh, I don't know.
Razor, do you mean you don't want to know about your real parents?
I want to know, but don't want to know.
So you do want to know, but at the same time you don't want to know?
That is exactly what he just said.
Sounds complicated.
Traveler, come and take a look at the trap I just placed. Let's give Razor some space to process things. Yes, I have some thoughts about this after seeing how Razor reacted. We've been hunting together a lot recently. The kid might not talk much, but still, I feel like I've come to understand him a little over the time we've spent together. Here's what I think. He definitely wants to find out about his parents. It's just that his fear of the unknown is overwhelming everything else he's feeling. I'm a father myself, so I know a thing or two about kids. You know, when Diana was little, if I got back late from a hunt one night, she'd be watching me like
what?
A hawk for days afterwards, as if she was worried that I might abandon her.
Are you Diona's dad?
Do you mean Razor's worried that he was abandoned by his own parents?
How long has that been a thing?
Exactly. I think that's the heart of it. And if it turns out they did, well, I don't think there's anything we could say to console him. That's not my only concern, though. Razor is developing at his own pace. There are lots of issues that can't be solved all in one go, but he's making progress, one step at a time. But now this thing with his parents is added into the mix. It might push him to want to figure out once and for all where he comes from and where he's going.
Seems like a similar take to Lisa's. Maybe all mature adults think like this, huh? Wait, but then again, Master Jean had a different view. She said it's more about trusting other people, and in your own instincts. What do you think?
Gotcha. Well, knowing that he's got a friend like you to rely on makes me feel much better about this whole thing.
You tell Paimon about how you plan to approach the situation, but don't tell me.
Okay, got it. Right, let's head back. We don't want to keep him waiting. Hey, Razor, so what are your thoughts?
Still thinking. My heart, it feels strange. Like being stabbed by a wolf hook.
I know exactly what that feels like. Well, not minus the wolf hook part, because I don't know what that feels like.
Varka? Tall. Very strong. Likes to laugh. Yes. Trust. He's very good to me. Give me a name. Teach me to fight. But now, busy with important work, I miss him.
You know, Razor, Varka used up all the paper writing this letter, but he still made sure he found room on the back to add a note for Elisa. He specifically told her to give you the things that your parents left for you. That means that he thinks the items have a special meaning for you. But more importantly than that, whatever happens, the Traveler, Paimon, Lisa, and all your other friends will always be here for you.
That's right. And old Uncle Browncat's here to support you as well.
Okay. Thank you. I decide I want to go with you to see teacher.
That's the spirit, kiddo. Well, you folks better be heading off then. I'm just about finished here, so I'll be heading home very shortly myself. I'd better try and get plenty of father-daughter time in before the fine Laserfest starts.
Bye, Draft. See you again next time.
Oh god, what is this? When the West Wind Rises?
Why am I not surprised? Involved in the quest When the West Wind Rises. When the West Wind Rises. Oh god, is this her story quest? It is. You've got to be fucking kidding me. Can I do one fucking event in this game without some fucking bullshit like that happening every goddamn time I try to play this fucking game? It's really frustrating. Just says the quest location. It doesn't say that there's a character that's involved, which means maybe I could just start it and then tell it to fuck off. It's almost 2 a.m, so I guess. It should give me all the information that I needed to know. I have to pee. Hey, Jean? Genie Jean Jean? What the fuck? Okay. Behold, the Dandelion Knight herself? Yeah, this is really weird that they can't just make it so whatever quest is selected is whatever primary the NPCs are set to. I mean, I don't know how many countless other RPGs allow you to do that. I don't know why Genshin is incapable of being made that way.
Oh, it's our honorary knight. Sorry, I must have been daydreaming. How can I assist?
Actually, it's not us who need your help. It's a bunch of other people.
see. Well, thank you for your service to the people of Mondstadt. I have made a note of these commissions in my files, and I will make arrangements accordingly.
Great! We didn't miss out on anyone's commissions, did we? Sarah's Hilly Churls, Charles' tax return, Margaret's cat.
Yeah, so it was part of this.
We'll be on our way then, Jean. Jean, are you okay?
And now she's dead. Okay, well now we can go do the other quest. Something's wrong with Jean, and you bring her to the cathedral in search of assist. Who the hell is that?
Jean holding up? Is it serious?
It's just burnout from work stress. She'll be fine after a good old rest. Thanks for bringing her here. She may have tried to keep soldiering on otherwise.
It's not a surprise, though. She does have a lot to get through every day.
Poor Jean. She's always been one to push herself too hard while overlooking her own needs. This isn't the first time something like this has happened. You think so? I mean, she's the acting Grand Master and all. We can't have her collapsing all the time now, can we? So you know, it's not like this is a personal thing. It's just out of love for... concern for the greater good. Yes, that's it.
What's up with Barbara? Huh. Weird.
Anyway, you're an honorary knight, aren't you? While the Master is down, the knights should share her burden. No?
That's a very good point, but shouldn't one of the fully qualified knights do that?
Jean has so much to do. An extra pair of hands can't hurt. You should go and check in at the headquarters. Jean will be fine with just me here.
Paimon feels like she's trying to get rid of us.
Why is that?
Nothing. We'll leave you to it. Come on, let's go.
This must have definitely been really early because the subtitle didn't match up at all. Not even just one word, the whole fucking sentence wasn't there. Okay, so can I continue the other thing right now? I can. Okay. How freaking weird, man. Yeah, because it didn't say a character was being distracted, it just said the area was being used. Which then... which begs to ask the question, how come we started the Jean's story quest first, but the event was perfectly capable of allowing us into her office. It was only after I come back that I suddenly wasn't able to go in. It's so weird the way it works. I mean, I have literally never seen another game that has done it like this, or at least done it as bad. The worst it's ever been is like, you know, oh, this quest is going to, you know, end a storyline or whatever, so in order to proceed, you need to complete this other quest because it's literally the end of the fucking game. And once it's over, the game's over. But I don't know. It is what it is, I suppose.
Oh, it's Kaya!
I've been waiting for you.
Really? Well, I had to come in and then leave and then come back.
I have been informed about Jean falling ill. On behalf of all of the Knights of Favonius, allow me to express my sincere gratitude for your assistance.
Can I just go?
So courteous and polite. This isn't the Kaya Paimon knows.
Well, the circumstances warrant it. This is the acting Grand Master herself we're talking about.
Now,
in addition to that thank you message, there was one other thing. It's like you read my mind. We have quite a connection, don't you think?
No, I'm just trying to do the
things
event.
Like helping to fill in for Jean?
Right. Although the commissions you reported to Jean have already been handed off to someone else, I am concerned that they will not be handled with due care without Jean's personal touch. So I am hoping that you can help out where you see fit. I will feel much more at ease knowing that the honorary knight is personally overseeing these cases.
You can flatter us all you want, but answer me this. Why don't you do it?
Oh, I have far more important matters to attend to. There are so many things to prepare.
Fine, then. So it's Sarah, Charles, and Margaret's stuff you want us to help with, right?
Those are the ones. I appreciate the help. See.
Okay, now the dialogue's also just cutting off. That's interesting. Okay, now I've got three random quests. That didn't fuck up any of my bullshit, did it? No, it didn't. Okay. Yeah, they're all part of the same story quest. Well, I don't mean to do them, like, impartially, and then go to do something else, and then have to do them impartially, and then go to do something else. That's the way the game's forcing me to do it. When the time is right, I will get them done. I've never been incapable of doing so.
Lisa, we brought Razor!
Hello, teacher. I'm here to see the box.
Ah, my little wolf cub's in a good mood. I'm assuming they've discussed the whole story with you already?
Wolf cub, she said. That's great.
Here, this is it.
Holy shit!
Box. I haven't touched it, except for taking it out of the cabinet. When you're sure you're ready, you can open it yourself.
A huge fucking box. I was thinking like a little, yes. Like, you hold in the palm of your hand. What kind of loot's gonna be inside? Some primitive gems, maybe?
This is just a pile of junk!
Whoa!
I thought there'd at least be a letter or something!
It's kind of rude, Paimon.
You don't think that, after all this time, Varka might be getting mixed up between different boxes?
It literally has a wolf box.
There is a scent.
A scent? What kind?
A scent I remember from a long, long time ago. It's their scent. Human scent. Father and mother's scent.
Oh, incredible. You still remember scents from all the way back in your childhood.
Wow. You have a really good sense of smell, Razor. Guess being wild by nature has its advantages. Oh, let's see what other leads we can find. This woolen hand puppet looks kind of wonky. Guess it must be handmade, huh? Is this a part from a ruin guard? Wait! Hey, look! This wine bottle is still half full! And there's a note stuck on it. Thousand Wind Wine.
Oh, so it's a bottle of Thousand Wind Wine?
Teacher, you know?
Of course. Thousand Wind Wine was the first kind of wine that Mondstadters ever learned to make, or so they say. As to how it got its name, some say it's a reference to the numerous ingredients used to make it, while others say it's because every bottle tastes slightly different.
What?
I remember reading somewhere that there are all sorts of weird and wonderful ways of brewing it, and that it's very difficult to ensure it comes out tasting the same each time. This all makes it impractical to commercialize. Wine merchants are much more comfortable working with reliable, consistent-tasting products. That's why you'll almost never see Thousand Wind Wine in the markets or taverns. Huh. In fact, it looks like your parents brewed this bottle themselves.
That must mean there's something pretty important about it. Oh! Paimon has an idea! Razor, you got a good nose. Why don't you open it up and take a whiff? Maybe it'll tell you something.
Okay.
Smells like shit.
He seems really in the zone. And is that a smile?
Find anything?
Sweet. Cold. A little bitter. I like. Many things all mixed together. But things in wine smell different.
Even you can't tell what it is, Razor?
I will try again.
It's okay, Razor. Don't push yourself too hard. What do we do when we try something and it doesn't work?
Try again.
Try another way.
Sort of.
That's right. You still remember what I taught you? Oh, it's almost the Vine Lisa Fest. Everyone who knows anything worth knowing about wine will be gathering in Mondstadt. Surely someone will know a thing or two about Thousand Wind wine.
Oh, great idea!
Make sure you don't miss the opening ceremony, Kirti. Everyone will be there. Razor, you should go too. It'll be a good opportunity to ask around.
Okay. Ask many people. I will try.
Don't worry. We'll be right there with you. We can be your go-betweens. You know, like you were with the wolves for Draft.
Okay. Then I will go back now. I need to tell Lupakal about human mother and human father.
Great! See you at the opening ceremony!
And then they get pissed off and start ripping him to shreds because he's no longer a wolf boy.
As Razor's teacher, I'm so happy to see him taking this first step. And you must be tired from running around trying to find Razor. Why don't you rest here a while? I'll make you a nice cup of tea.
From what? What are the ingredients for the tea? Where'd you get the tea from? Where'd the liquid come from? Why does it taste kind of like piss? Wait for the Vine Lisa Fest from 8 to 10. 2 days later. 2 days? What time is it? All right. Okay, so the dailies, the weeklies will be swooping over soon. I would really like to find this 99% so it can be 100%, because then all of Mondstadt will be 100% for the most part. God, it could be anywhere, that's the problem. Well, I need to pee before we go to the next spot, so I think what I'm going to do... Oh, that was a different effect. That wasn't the effect we had before. It was like a Klee effect. I would like to get my compass out again. I'm just gonna have a little peek around and just see if there's anything at all that I'm missing in this area of Mondstadt. It's not on one of those islands, is it? Because I know we had to figure shit out at the island. Like, I can see a statue over there, but I remember I thought we did that. Oh shit, I didn't realize there was like a dam over there of rock. I guess because that's all off-map stuff for the most part. Okay, well I'm gonna- let me just double check this. But I'm pretty sure we did this. Because I remember saying that I needed a green character. Because I think activating- all that it does when you activate this is bring up like a current that you can use. Oops. Here we go.
My experiment.
And then over here, I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know, it's gonna take us 10 years to find this last bit of loot that we need. The hell, there's loots out here. I think there was an Oculus out here originally, up one of these. Yeah, and this island has nothing on it. Baloney! Check one more spot, and then I'll go ahead and go pee, and then we'll skip to do the skip the days or whatever.
Well, since you
gonna keep her in my party, since I'll be doing something at some point. Oh shit. What the fuck?
Yay, shiny.
You have got to be fucking kidding me.